Everyone, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. For those of you who do not know, my name is Danielle and I am a licensed cosmetologist. And here on my channel, I post a lot of vlogs, hairdressing related videos, hairdresser vlogs, and pretty much just everything. So if you haven't already subscribed, make sure to hit that big red subscribe button, and also don't forget to follow me on all of my social medias. I always have them listed down below. But for today's video, this video is for all of you clients out there who are struggling with explaining to your hairdresser what you want. Communication is so important when it comes to you and your hairdresser. And with all this new terminology, all the new trends and styles that are going around right now, I know it can be hard sometimes to kind of pinpoint out what you want. And I know it's hard to explain to your hairstylist what you're looking for. So I figured for today's video, I would give you guys some tips, tricks, and advice from hairdresser herself on ways to help you guys better explain to your stylist what you're looking for. So if you're someone who struggles with this, definitely keep on watching. So in my opinion, and I think this goes for 90% of us hairdressers, pictures are so helpful. Whether it's a picture from Pinterest, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok nowadays, I know so many clients find TikToks and like try to screenshot a TikTok video to show me someone's hair, and I think it's hilarious, but hey, you gotta do what you gotta do. Google images, a magazine, literally anything that you find a picture of and you're like, this is what I want, just show it to your hairdresser and we can go from there. I find that Pinterest has the best options for pictures and they're always the best quality, and all you have to do is search specific keywords that you're looking for and pretty much most of the time exactly what you're looking for is going to show up. Even if you find a picture that you're not 100% set on, but there's something in that picture that you love, just show it to your hairdresser and point out exactly what you like in that picture. For example, I have so many people who do this. They'll show me like three different pictures, but they all kind of look different. So I like to have them show me each individual picture and I say, okay, what do you like about each one of these? And usually for each different picture, they like different things. So that kind of helps your hairdresser know too, like, okay, she likes how the roots look in this picture, but she likes how the tone is in this picture. Then she likes the cut in this picture. Like, it's so much to take into consideration, but pictures really, really do help us a lot, and they help you as well. Although pictures are amazing, they can also sometimes have their downfalls. So a few things to keep in mind when showing your hairstylist a picture is that it's going to look different in all different kinds of lightings. Most of the time, my clients will show me pictures in natural light, which basically means like nice bright sunlight sometimes, but I always like to let them know that it will look like that sometimes in the sunlight, but other times, whether it's dark, if you're in yellow lighting, if you're in the shade, like it's always going to look different in different lightings. So keep that in mind. And even if you're wondering like, oh, I love this picture, I know it's in bright light, is it going to look a lot different in this sort of light? Like, you can ask your stylist that and they will be 100% honest with you. Also keep in mind that your picture might be a wig. I have been in this situation where a client sent me a picture and I just knew right away that it was a wig. Like, yeah, don't get me wrong, it looks great, but it's probably not going to look exactly like that because it's a wig. Sometimes hairstylists can pinpoint out wigs, sometimes you can't. It's really hard, but with this specific picture, I was like, that's a wig. But yes, just keep that in mind as well. Another major thing to keep in mind with pictures is that 80% of the time, you do not have the same hair type as the person in the picture. You could have the thickest hair ever and show me a picture of someone with like hair like mine, super thin and straight. And your hairdresser is mostly going to let you know that it's not going to look exactly the same because your hair is 3,000 times thicker than the picture. Which goes into my next thing. Imagine the hair on you. If someone shows me an image of Madison Beer's hair, don't imagine it on Madison Beer. Imagine it on you. Do you think it is going to look good on you? Sometimes hairstylists will be upfront with you and be like, personally, I think this will look a little bit better for your face shape or your skin tone, your eye color. There's so much that goes into it. But yes, just think what this hairstyle is going to look like on you. Because ultimately, that's all that matters. You're the one that's wearing it, you know? Okay, so now I want to talk about haircuts. I feel like haircuts can be the most tricky with explaining to your hairdresser exactly what you want. Again, pictures, pictures, pictures. Show your hairstylist pictures, and then we'll ask you questions from there. I feel like right now I've been doing a ton of face frame haircuts, and it's good to know the difference between face frame and curtain bangs. Because I have a lot of clients that kind of think they're the same thing, but I have to explain to them that they're totally not. So face framing is when you start at whatever lowest point you want. Usually I do face frame around like the neck area being the shortest piece. So anywhere from like the chin to mid neck. And then from that point, you cut at a very steep angle all the way down to the actual length of the hair. And then once it's blow dried, it pretty much just frames your face, gives you a little bit of extra volume, gives you a sort of layered look. And if you get them short enough, like to the chin area, it leaves for really cute pieces if you have your hair up and have like the two little pieces in front. I think that is so cute and so trendy right now. But then you have curtain bangs, which is very different. So curtain bangs kind of has the same idea, but instead of having like a tiny piece on each side that reaches your chin, you have a thicker section that usually, it depends on the client, but usually lays around like cheekbone to chin area, which as the client, you need to know. Do you want them to sit at your cheekbone? Do you want them to sit at your chin? Do you want them to sit around your mouth? So definitely think about that before going into the salon, because that could really depend on whether or not you like the result. But yes, so ultimately you have a thicker section, and then once you blow dry them, they kind of just swoop out, and then you have the rest of the hair that's kind of blended down as well. So definitely, definitely think about each one of those and determine whether you're more into the face frame or more into the curtain bangs. Again, with curtain bangs, it requires a lot more maintenance than face frame. So keep that in mind as well. Next, for layers, layers can be super tricky because there's so many. There's long layers, inversion layers, square layers, round layers. Like, there are just so many. Other layers definitely look better with different lengths of hair. So for my mom, she has a really short haircut, and I like to do square layers on her, just because it gives it more of a stacked look since her hair is so short. But if you have really, really long hair, anything from inversion or round layers, or as most of my clients say, long layers would look a lot better on longer hair. There's so many pictures out there that will kind of give you an idea of what the layers you're looking for look like. Personally, I don't think the client really needs to know what the layer is called. As long as you show your hairstylist a picture of what kind of layers you're looking for, they should automatically know. But just in case the hairstylist asks you, do you want the layers to be subtle? Do you want them to be more prominent, more stacked? So definitely just kind of think about those words if you're looking for layers. Oh, this one. Okay. This kind of goes for me a little bit. But we've got the bob and the lob, okay? Bobs and lobs are only a little bit different just because with a lob, it's considered a long bob. So it's more angled in the front as opposed to a bob, which is kind of just like straight across all the way around. Which that's a pretty simple question to answer. Like, do you want it angled in the front or do you want it just straight across? But yes, if you're interested in getting a really, really short haircut, like to your collarbones or up, I would definitely look up pictures of a bob and a lob separately and kind of determine what you think would look better on you. Personally, on my specific face shape, I loved the angle in the front. I feel like it just makes everything more structured. But I'm currently growing my hair out, so we're kind of at that awkward stage right now. So ignore that. But yes, definitely look into lobs and bobs separately, because sometimes with a bob, if you don't specify that you don't want it stacked, the hairdresser might just go ahead and make it stacked and it won't be what you're looking for, and you'll realize it's like extremely short in the back. So if you're set on having it just one simple length all around, just say that. Ooh, next I have thinning slash texturizing. This is so important. Like, I can't even explain this to you. The hairstylist sometimes takes this into their own hands and won't even let the client know, and they'll kind of just texturize it or thin it out without saying anything. There are certain circumstances where I will just go ahead and do it depending on the client's thickness. Like, if your hair is extremely thick and we just cut like 6 inches off of your hair, oh, trust me, I am going to be thinning and texturizing your hair. I will let you know ahead of time, but I'm gonna do it. But if there are some clients that have like medium to thin hair, definitely ask first. Be like, hey, I know we cut off like an inch or two. Would you be interested in thinning or texturizing? And for texturizing, it kind of just means removing any weight that might be caused from like such a blunt line that you cut, and it'll kind of just make it feel a lot smoother and it'll be easier to like drag your hands through after texturizing. But sometimes there are clients who are like, do not thin my hair out. It is already so thin. Do not do it. Do not do any of that. But if the hairstylist thinks it's appropriate, they'll kind of just help you understand, like, it's going to make your hair feel so much better. So as a client, you kind of just have to trust what the hairstylist is doing. But at the same time, if you know that your hair is thinning and like it's very thin, like, you can say something. But if you have really thick hair, just expect the hairstylist to possibly thin or texturize your hair. And last for haircuts, I have whether you want it choppy or clean. I know the word choppy sounds really scary, but my mom likes her hair to be more choppy than clean. So I'd say for my haircut, like right at the edge, it's very clean. Like, it's a very straight line. But sometimes people like the more like messy, ragged look. So definitely look into that for pictures too, if you're interested in that. Now moving on to hair color, so important. Knowing the difference between balayage and highlights. Balayage is like the new thing right now, and I've been doing a ton of them recently. They are just super trendy, super in right now. And it is so important to know the difference, because if you come in and you're like, ooh, I was on TikTok and this girl said that she got a balayage and I really want a balayage, and then I ask, oh, do you have any inspiration pictures? No, it's the word balayage. It's balayage. I want a balayage. I'll be like, okay. Any pictures? If they still don't give me a picture, I might just be like, do you like the rooted look into highlighted pieces, or do you like the highlights to be right up to the root? And then they'll be like, oh, I don't want roots. I want highlights right here. And I'll be like, okay, so maybe not a balayage today. And they'll be like, no, I want a balayage. TikTok said it was a balayage. Oh my god. And then you're just kind of like, okay. Sounds good. So yes, the main difference between balayage and highlights is that most of the time, balayage will have more of like a rooted look into a blended balayage, but with straight up highlights, you're going to see the highlights all the way up to the root. You can obviously do highlights with a root tap, a root smudge, but you will still see those dimensional highlights up here more than you would with a balayage. So definitely keep that in mind because that will help your hairdresser a lot. Because if you just say balayage, they're going to automatically sometimes be like, oh, perfect, balayage. Yes, super trendy. I know this is what she wants. And then they'll go ahead and proceed to do it. And what happens if you look at it and you're like, oh, it's like really dark up here. And then they're like, oh, well, that's like what the balayage pretty much looks like. What if you're like, oh, I don't like that? Then it has a big problem in the end. So definitely when you look up pictures, look at the difference between balayage and then highlights and determine which one you like better. Next, I have warm or cool tones. This is also very, very important. The hairstylist should ask you whether you like warm or cool tones, and if you're not really sure what that means, they should 100% explain to you. But if a hairdresser does not, it is so important to know and tell your hairdresser if you want warm or cool tones. So warm tones in our language is like red, orange, yellow, and cool tones is like purple, blue, green. But in a client's world, they think green, blue. No, I don't want my hair to be blue or green. Or I don't want my hair to be red, but it's not like that. So we look at it different than you do. So say you want to be a platinum silver blonde, that would be a cool tone. But if you wanted a balayage, but like more caramel, we would consider that warm tone. So if you're kind of unsure, definitely look up like warm tone highlights versus cool tone highlights and determine which one you like better. Next, I have darker or lighter roots. So let's say you have a really blonde balayage. I actually have a client that has like a level 10 balayage and it is so beautiful, but she is obsessed with dark roots. Like, I love her hair, she pulls it off so good, but sometimes people don't really like that look because it's so dark up top and then like boom, blonde on the bottom. I think it is gorgeous, but if you're someone who isn't really into that look, definitely let your hairstylist know. That way they can determine whether or not to even do a root, to just like leave your natural the way it is, or to do a root but make it lighter or darker. So definitely take that into consideration. Oh my god, this one is so important. We have dimensional versus solid. Okay, this is like, I feel like with blondes, it's a lot harder to determine whether you want it dimensional or solid. This is a solid blonde. This is a dimensional blonde. So let's say you go into the hair salon, you're a client, okay, and you have hair like mine, and you're really thinking about going blonde, but you want to be solid blonde. It is probably not going to happen the very first session because that would require to lighten every single strand of your hair blonde. Probably not even once, but twice, and that's a lot of damage. I know there are some hairstylists who might do that. Personally, I would probably do it in a few sessions just to keep the integrity of your hair. But if you do go to a salon and you're in that circumstance, just know you might get a dimensional blonde rather than a solid for the first session. All the dimensional really means is that instead of having every single strand of your hair blonde, you have a few darker pieces in between that create dimension. Personally, I love dimensional blondes. I love all the different tones, especially when you curl it. But if you're set on being a solid color, definitely talk to your hairstylist about that and be upfront, because if you're just like, I just want to be blonde, like get a balayage, it's most likely going to be dimensional. And if you're not into that, then it might be really bad in the end. So definitely talk to your hairdresser about that. And then I also have face frame and money piece. Money pieces are also very trendy right now, but there is a difference between face frame and money piece. So with money piece, the way I see it is that pretty much like this much of the hair in the front is going to be 100% blonde all the way to the root. But usually if you get a money piece, I'll root tap it a little just so that it blends seamlessly and you don't have like a harsh line of blonde with your natural hair. But yes, money piece is like straight up blonde in the front. Or if you're thinking about more of just face frame, which is like blended up, which is lighter in the front but doesn't go all the way to the root, definitely tell your hairstylist which one you prefer. There are so many pictures on Pinterest of money pieces versus face frame. So consider both of them, think about which one you're more into, and specify that with your hairstylist. And then the last thing that is so important for hair color is maintenance. If you are someone that does not want to go to the salon every 6 to 8 weeks and spend money to make your hair look great every single time, then highlights all the way to the root might not be your best bet. A balayage might be something to look into, because with a balayage, when your hair grows out, it'll grow out very seamlessly. But with highlights to the root, it can be a little bit tricky, because once your roots start to grow out, you'll be more likely to see the lines rather than a balayage, which is blended up into your natural. I always ask my clients about maintenance. I'm like, are you someone who really just isn't up for coming to the salon a lot and getting their hair done, or do you not mind coming in to get frequent glazes, frequent haircuts, touch-ups on your blonde? Like, if you're not someone that is into that, definitely tell your hairstylist. Or if you are someone who's like that, do tell your hairstylist and they'll kind of work something out for you. But please, please, please let your hairstylist know. Because if you aren't a maintenance person and you get something that is very high maintenance, it is not going to work out for you. All right, you guys, so that is everything that I wanted to talk about in today's video. I really hope this helped you and you feel a little bit more confident with communicating with your hairstylist. If you have any other questions, feel free to comment them down below. But I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe, follow me on all of my social medias, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, guys!